in the book of Romans, chapter 5, verse 20, this glorious word is written, where sin increased, the grace of God increased all the more. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Where the sin increased, the grace of God increased all the more. Yes. We have a mighty God with us. We know in the gospel there are three ways through which Satan tried to tempt Jesus. Before that we find Jesus, after receiving the baptism, he empowers himself with two important facts of life. Number one, he is filled with the Holy Spirit and he hears the voice of God. He is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. And in the form of a dove, the Holy Spirit came and sat on his shoulders. You and I are living in the world which is filled with the sin, Satan, and the temptations of evil. But we are not thrown away to live at the mercy of these evil elements. But we are living to live a victorious life by the one who has loved us and gave his life for us. So we need to do three things. And the master taught us in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 4. When Jesus was hungry, Satan came and told him, look at these stones, man. When Jesus was all the time looking at the Father in him, nourish himself with the Father, Satan says, look at the stones. Look at this earth. You are amidst the stones. The heat is coming from the stone. You look at your stomach. Your stomach is hungry. Is it needed for you? You are living in a very hot world. This, it's not worth it to remain here. Get out of this place. This desert full of stones and sand, heat, run away from here. You are hungry. It is not worth. The enemy will come as though he is trying to help you. He will try to magnify the world and your flesh. He will try to instigate what you can get out of the flesh, what you can get out of the world, and he will tie you up with your flesh and with this world. That is his game. But look at the Lord. The Lord took a word of God from the book of Deuteronomy and said, man cannot live by bread alone, but by every word man lives. Here, the Lord manifested the secret that the word of God will make you to live. You have the greatest power, as Ephesians 6:21 says, the sword of the Spirit is the word of God. The moment you recognize you have life through the word, Jesus said in John 6:63, he said, the words that I have spoken, your flesh is useless, man, but the words that I have spoken to you will give you my life, will adorn you with my Holy Spirit. Yes. And you and I are endowed with this mighty power, the life, through the word of God. Whenever you speak the word, you will experience life in you. He takes care of, he will turn everything into good for those who love him. We have the greatest treasure of life. If you open that treasure, you get life out of it. Yes. Every time. So Jesus said to Satan, we have the life through the word. Man cannot live by bread alone. But we have something that makes us to live all the time by the word of God. So I need not to bother about my life. I have the source. The moment I need, I will get it. So conscious of the word of God, conscious of it is the word that gives us life and spirit, is must for us to conquer the power of darkness that come to attack our lives. But he is a defeated one. Our life is full of temptations, pain and misery. But we need not be afraid. We have the greatest key. What is the key? The word of God. When we confess the word, whatever the word has spoken, the Holy Spirit has spoken, he will come and fulfill that word. Yes. Because our thoughts are different. The enemy will try to attack our thoughts. Yes. When Gideon was chosen by God to rule the people of Israel for 40 years, the enemy came and tried to attack him. The book of Judges, chapter 6, verse 12, what did he say? If God is with you, why these things are happening to you? Second, if God is with you, why not a single miracle is taking in your life? If God is with you, things will not be like this. Maybe God has left you. 3 bombs he put, but Gideon came out of all that. He knew the Lord. He believed in the word. The word said, to your God, you are a mighty warrior. God is with you. He believed in the word and he brought light out of his darkness. When he called for the war, 32,000 people came. The Lord said, if you go with 32,000 people and win the Armenians and win the your enemies, you will say that victory came through you, Midianites. So send those people who are frightened. Then 22,000 people went away. 10,000 people are left out. The Lord said, even this is too much. And at the end, he chose 300 people. And he told them, all of you go into 3 different directions. Carry the mud pot. And inside the mud pot, you keep your torch. And in a particular time, you break the jar and allow the light to come out of the darkness, to shine in the darkness. And from 3 directions, the light was coming towards the Midianites and Armenians. And when you come with the light, darkness loses its power. The enemies, they began to kill each other and they died. And Gideon had a wonderful, great victory. Our life is like, we carry the life of God in this clay pot, our body. We have to allow the light to come out of our body. We have to allow the light to come out of this world. And then the enemy will disappear from our lives. They will be killed. That's why in Psalm 18, verse 28 to 29, it is written, let the light of God shine in darkness. We are not the people remaining in darkness and seeking the light, but we bring the light, take the light into darkness. This is what we proclaim the word, the light That's why Jesus said in John's Gospel chapter 1 verse 4 and 5, he came into the world as the light and he shines in darkness. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word became light, and that light shines in darkness, and the darkness could not overcome it. What a great word. When you proclaim the word, when you open your mouth and proclaim the word of God, light will come. Through light, life will come. Darkness will disappear. So many temptations, so many disturbances, so many ways of evil will come and attack you. Don't worry about darkness. You need not to fight with the darkness. God has not called you to fight with the darkness. Lit the light. Lit the word. Hold on to the word, which is the sword of the spirit. The enemy will be destroyed. Hold on to the promises of God. Continue to proclaim. Man will live by the word. So to live a conqueror life, victorious life, God has called you and me. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.